In the golden age of piracy, there was no electricity, air conditioning, sunblock, refrigeration, radio, or TV. We know what pirates did, but how did they really live? What did they do when they weren't attacking merchant ships? I guess a good place to start would be the most essential needs, food and water. We often take food and water for granted today, but for a sailor in the 18th century, it was totally different. Food staples for ships of the day would have included salted meats and fish, sauerkraut, bone soup, and ship's biscuit. Ship's biscuit, also known as hardtack, is a simple type of biscuit made from flour, water, and salt. This stuff lasted forever. In fact, there are still surviving biscuits from the 1850s. The downside was that ship's biscuits were very bland and very hard. The sailors would soften it by dunking it into coffee, brine, or other liquids, or cooking it into meals. It was common to put some ship's biscuit in a bag and pound it with a mallet to crumble it into fine particles and used it to thicken soups, and it was a key ingredient in chowders from the 1700s. Another gross feature of ship's biscuit was the reality that it often contained insect larvae like weevils. Sailors commonly referred to the biscuits as worm castles. Imagine picking the bugs out of your food being a daily ritual before dinner. Occasionally, the sailors might have also mixed powdered biscuits with sugar, hot water, and some rum to create a dessert. Speaking of water, that was another problem for pirates. Water was stored in wooden barrels, but it spoiled quickly on board a ship. Contamination was another issue because men would dip their cups directly into the barrels to get a drink. Oftentimes on a pirate ship, the men would drink straight rum, beer, or wine as well. Rum was readily available in the Caribbean and was often being transported on merchant ships, so it made a lot of sense for pirates to have developed a taste for it. I should mention that the mixing of rum with water, known as grog, was not yet invented in the golden age of piracy. It's not to say that it was never done, but it was not typical and not referred to as grog until after 1740. Some ships could have also carried livestock like chickens, goats, and sometimes a cow. If they had goats or cows, they would have had a source of milk. And if they wanted to, they can slaughter the cow for beef as well. As far as shelter goes, when at sea, obviously the pirates lived on board their ships. They would sleep wherever they could find room, amongst the stolen cargo, either on deck or below deck. Below deck would have stunk. In addition to the body odors of the men, because deodorant had not yet been invented, the bilge had a terrible odor. The bilge is the lowest point in a ship where water naturally settles. This water came from tiny leaks in the hull, spills, and rain, and would carry dirt, oil, and grime with it. In rough seas, pirates would inevitably get seasick, and some of their vomit would get washed into the bilge as well. This water would turn putrid quick, and would definitely add to the smell. Another issue would have been the heat. Ships were not built for comfort, and there really was no way to provide adequate ventilation in the hold of a ship aside from the gun ports. The hot, tropical sun would have been beating down on the deck all day, and any light would be coming from candles or lanterns, which would also add to the heat. Combined with the body heat that a large crew produced, I'm sure it was absolutely awful to be down there. If the pirates had hammocks, they would have slept in them, strung between the guns and cargo. The crew would have slept together aside from maybe the captain, who would have gotten a private room. It wouldn't have been anything fancy, but he would have had a little more privacy. It really would have depended on the ship and the crew. Some captains slept with the crew, while others did not. Going to the bathroom was done at the bow, or the front of the ship, on either side of the bowsprit. Some ships would have had simple toilets there, while others would have had nothing more than some rope for a sailor to hold on to while he did his business. The reason they were located in the front was because the wind was primarily behind the ship, and this way they wouldn't get waste on the hull. The captain's quarters might have had a toilet for his personal use, and if so, it would have been in the stern of the ship. Personal hygiene was not well practiced aboard a ship, as the water was reserved for drinking and watering the animals. Most of the sailors could not swim, and even if they were able to, they would not dare jump into the water for fear of sharks. Sharks routinely follow ships because the waste is dumped overboard, which attracts all types of smaller fish that sharks feed on. They likely wouldn't have been brushing their teeth much either, and laundry wouldn't have been done unless the pirate was in port. Pirates would listen to music while they were looking to pass the time. A crew would usually have several musicians, and in addition, sailors would often sing during monotonous work. Pirates would also smoke pipes on the open decks, read, gamble, and tell stories when they had some downtime. A pirate needed to maintain their weapons, and that meant sharpening their swords and knives, as well as oiling their pistols. They might also engage in target practice with both pistols as well as cannon. All ships needed to be kept in good working order, so pirates would tar the lines, mend the sails, scrub the decks, and so on. Every few months, a ship would need to be beached so the pirates could careen it. This meant removing barnacles and other growth from the hull, and it was a very dangerous job. The ship was brought in at high tide, and when the water receded, it would be pulled over to one side so they could scrape the hull. Aside from the danger of the ship accidentally sliding back and crushing someone, it also left them vulnerable to pirate hunters or military patrols. Any legal merchant ship would have done this in port, so it would be very obvious that the pirates were up to no good if a ship caught them in the act. A short life and a merry one was a saying amongst pirates, and it isn't hard to see why. Pirates certainly had more freedom than the average sailor of the day, along with the opportunity to make considerable money. But in almost all cases, the trade-off was a shorter life. Do you think the trade-off was worth it? Let us know in the comments below. If you liked this video today, please subscribe and give us a like. There is also a link to our PayPal and Patreon below.